Hello, everyone. It's Miss Joyce from the Euclid Library, and I'm here to do a story time. Today's stories are going to be all about monsters, but they will be friendly monsters, not scary monsters. Okay. And the first story has a monster in it that looks a little like this, although he's much bigger. But the monsters like this that have the one eye in the middle, that's a cyclops. Like I said, they're friendly. So our first story is called Rude Cakes by Robot Watkins. And it is published by Chronicle Books. Rude Cakes never say please. Gimme, he says. And they never say thank you. Happy birthday, it really flies. I hate dots. So he's not very happy with his present and he's not very nice about it. And they sometimes take things that don't belong to them. Here's that guy crying. Oh, yes. Rude cakes never listen. It's time to go. La, 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 la. That means now, mister, especially when their parents sound boring. And they don't wait their turn in line. Back off, I'm going again. That's not very nice. Rude cakes never share, and they're never sorry. You clumsy crumb, because they're never ever wrong. That's not right either. They also think bads are dumb. Oh, come on, I'm a cake, how dirty can I be? And that bedtime is for donut holes. That doesn't sound like sleeping to me. I don't know if you can tell, but he's jumping on his bed. Oddly enough, here goes Rude Cakes and his stuffed friend, Giant Cyclopses. There he is. Love to wear jaunty little hats. Wow, what a great hat. Thanks. Giant Cyclopses always say thank you. Hat? Oh, can I please try on your hat sometime? And they always say please. Yes, they love to share. He's up there saying, I am not a hat. Giant Cyclopses also love to wait their turn. I'm the cutest hat. That's the cutest hat ever. I even heard it dances. I love your dancing hat. I am not a hat. Please. Giant Cyclopses always listen when their hats say please nicely. They want to hear sounds boring. I'm not a hat, I'm a tired cake and I just want to go to bed. And they always apologize when they're wrong. So look at how nice he is. He took them and put them back to bed. Of course, no cake is ever too rude to change. So here he is, he's sharing with everybody. Awesome. See, so it isn't good to be rude. It's much nicer to be nice, take turns and share all those fun things. So we have some monsters and I wanted to do a little rhyme with you first about the monster who's going to go and eat some cakes. So we're going to have, let's count these. One here, let's take down our monster sign and put up our cakes. Cupcakes, one, two, three, four, five. Did you count them with me? There's our five cupcakes. And then I have he's really just a friendly monster though. All right. Down around the corner at the bakery shop were 5 yummy cakes, cupcakes with sprinkles on top. And along comes Monster with a dollar to pay. He buys a cupcake and takes it away. Ooh, how many cupcakes are left now? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, 4 cup down around the corner at the bakery shop were 4 yummy cupcakes with a cherry on top. Along comes Monster with a dollar to pay. He buys the cupcake and takes it away. Now how many are left? 1, 2, 3. Down around the corner in the bakery shop were 3 yummy cupcakes with a cherry on top. Along comes the Monster with a dollar to pay. He takes that cupcake away. And how many are left now? 1, 2, 2 little cupcakes. Down around the corner at the bakery shop were 2 yummy cupcakes with a cherry on top. Along comes Monster with a dollar to pay. He buys that cupcake and takes it away. Oh, how many are left? Down around the corner at the bakery shop, there's 1 yummy cupcake with a cherry on top. And along comes Monster with a dollar to pay. And he buys that cupcake and takes it away. Oh, there we go, Mr. Monster. All right. All right. How about if you guys want to do, let's do our next story, who's almost looks like a monster, almost like my monster. It is called Frank Was a Monster Who Wanted to Dance. And this is by Keith Graves and published by Chronicle Books. And he is a very silly monster also. Ready? All right. Frank was a monster who wanted to dance. I know I could boogie if I just got the chance. So he put on his hat and his shoes made in France, and he opened a jar and put some ants in his pants. How silly is that? But that's gonna make him dance, isn't it? If you had ants in your pants, yahoo, he says. He drove to the theater and jumped on stage. Then he danced like his shoe size instead of his age. Check this out. Yahoo! Frank shook his shoulders and shuffled his stuff. Then the audience screamed. They couldn't get enough. Fabulous. Wahoo! Frank did a cartwheel. He did a flip. Suddenly, his head began to unzip. Uh-oh, there's the zipper. Out flipped his brains. Ugh, which plopped on the floor. Yuck. Which loosened his eyeball, which rolled on to the door. And after his arm fell out of his sleeve, the horrified audience started to leave. Oops. Yuck, ack, run, run. But Frank kept dancing. He said, what the heck? Ha, ha, ha. And he laughed as his head fell off of his neck. He said to himself with one-eyed glance, I might be a monster, but man, can I dance. Is that a silly story or what? Yes, all right. So how about if we decide, let's stand up and we're gonna do a little bit of pretending that we're monsters, okay? So let's stand up. Everybody standing up and we're gonna pretend we're a monster. So if you were a happy monster, what would you do? If I were a happy monster, ha ha ha, I'd be laughing, yay. How about if I was a sad monster? Let's see a sad monster. Boo-hoo, boo-hoo. How about if you're a mad monster, stomp those feet. Mad, mad, mad. Oh. And if I were a scared monster, I'd be like, oh. But it's just me. I am not a monster. So instead, what would I like to do? I'd like to read my books, especially ones about monsters. Okay. So we pretended we're monsters. And we're going to do a little song about monsters. If you're ready, let's try this song. This one is by Lori Berkner and Lori Berkner's band, and it is called The Monster Boogie. So we're going to pretend we're monsters. Ready? You big monster. Instead of teddy bear, we're gonna do monster, monster, okay? Ready? Monster, monster, turn around. Monster, monster, touch the ground. Monster, monster, reach up high. Monster, monster, squint your eyes. Monster, monster, show your teeth. Monster, monster, stomp your feet. Monster, monster, slap your knees. Monster, monster, sit down, please. All right, so we're sitting back down. I wanted to share another story with you. This one you might know. This one is called Go Away, Big Green Monster by Ed Emberley, and it's published by Scholastic. What I'm going to do with this book, instead of showing you the book, is I'm going to do it with my puppet. So here we have the green monster's face. He's got a scary face with two yellow eyes. Two big yellow eyes. And then what might he need? Yes, a nose. A long bluish greenish nose. And then he needs, yeah, what do you think? Yes, his ears. Now his ears do not look anything like our ears. They look more like horns, don't they? Yes, there's his ears, two squiggly ears. And then he has, what's on top of our head? Yes, hair. Now his hair, it's not the colors of our hair unless we dye it, because what color is his hair? Purple. Yes, pretty silly. All right, so he's got purple hair. What else does he need now? He needs his mouth. So here's his mouth. But in order for it to be the right mouth, he needs to have the red. And then you can see his sharp teeth. And there, now he looks like a big scary monster, doesn't he? So, but we know he's just a puppet. So, go away, big scary monster. Go away. Go away with your purple hair. And go away with your two squiggly ears. And go away with your long nose. And go away with your two big eyes. And go away with those, your mouth and your sharp teeth. And that's all that's left. So go away and don't ever come back. All right, see, so we know monsters we don't need to be scared of, at least none of these monsters. They're just pretend monsters. Okay. So, and then I wanted to do another little rhyme with you. Let's do some monsters here. Remember my Sturge and my Cyclops? And do you know what color is he? Can you tell? Sometimes it's hard to tell with the colors on the screen, but he's red. So we have a red monster. And what color is this guy? Yellow, a yellow monster, and blue, a blue monster. Good. And then what color is this guy? Green. Yes, there's our green monster and purple monster. Good. And this one's an orange one. He almost looks like a Cyclops too. He's got that one eye. All right, so there's our monsters and we should count them. How many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, we have 6 scary monsters. All right, 6 scary monsters dancing the monster jive. One runs away and now there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes. 5 scary monsters howling out a roar. One runs away. And now there are 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 scary monsters hiding in a tree. One fell out. And now there are 3. 1, 2, 3. 3 scary monsters eating spider stew. Mm-mm-mm. One got sick, and now there are 2 scary monsters having lots of fun. One runs off, and that leaves 1. 1 scary monster afraid to be a hero. He runs away, and that leaves 0. Yes. All right, good job, everybody. All right, so those are our monster stories and monster rhymes. I'm hoping you had fun today with our stories. And if you ever want to come and do, we have story times virtually at the library on Tuesdays at 10:30 and 6:30 and on Thursdays at 10:30. So come and join us whenever you can. It's very hard now with what's going on, but we hope to see you. And I will end with one more little rhyme. So if everybody wants to stand up, and we're gonna tickle the clouds and then tickle our toes and then turn around and touch our nose, reach down low and reach up high. Story time is over, so wave goodbye. I hope everybody had fun and I hope to see you again soon. Bye-bye.